Hello, this is Lynn from WisconsinGarden.org, and today is Saturday morning. It's Farmer's Market Day. There's only three left for the whole summer, and then it's done until spring. So I begged, and my husband said, sure, let's go. And what did we find but apples? I wasn't about to buy apples today, but when we got to the farmer's market, we were talking to the woman about her apples and what kind I should use to make applesauce. She said, you're always best using a variety of apples because the flavors mingle and it's much tastier. So she also suggested that we use apples that are called seconds or drops, the ones that fall off the tree that aren't picked. So they're not as beautiful as the ones that you would buy in the store or if you would get them at a farmer's market. Some of them have little bruises on them. Some are misshapen. Some are a little smaller. Some have little spots. None of that matters when you're making applesauce. So these were perfect, and they're about half the price, a third to a half of the price as you would pay for the perfect apples. You're going to squish them up anyway. Who is going to see them? So we loaded up, got our 10 bags, $3 a bag, so do the math. We thought it was a pretty good deal, and it's going to be so delicious in the winter. Then the next step is to wash them, because they've been outside, figure. They've had poison on them. People have touched them. They've fallen on the ground. They've been in boxes. So you want to wash them. I like to put just a drop or two of dish detergent in there, just because it helps the soil come off better. And you're going to rinse them anyway, so it doesn't matter. I also like to scrub where the stem is and where the blossom end is, because that's where the majority of the dirt is going to be. And then as you get them done, just rinse them off. After that stage, you go to the next stage, which is quartering. Leave the skin on. Many people just do this. They take it, they quarter it, they throw it in the pot. I like to take off the very edge where the stem would be, because that's where poison would settle in if there was any residual poison. Then you toss it in the pot. And you do that until your pot is nearly full, because they will cook down. Put in about an inch of water. Could be an inch of apple juice if you have apple juice. And you're going to keep them. You're going to cook them until they're mushy. Mushy, that you can stir them and the skins are falling off and you see seeds floating around in there, and you're thinking, ugh, this is awful. But then comes the next step when you put it through what's called a Foley mill. A Foley mill is a crank, and I'll bring it out later. But you take your apple mush, you put it in the Foley mill, you put the Foley mill over another pan, and you crank it by hand until all of the apple pulp is now in the bottom, and the seeds and the stems and all the little fingernail kind of things on the seed case are up in the Foley mill. Back, stir it, throw that in your compost. Once you have a pot of lovely applesauce, you're going to sweeten it a little bit with some sugar if you feel it needs sweetening. If you like to put cinnamon in, you put cinnamon in, and you cook it, and you bring it to not quite a boil, so it's just really hot. From that point, you put it into your warm jars, and then you put your jars into a water bath, just like canning tomatoes, except now it's applesauce, even better. So I will continue coring and cooking and show you the next step with the Foley mill. This is how high you can fill the pot, right to the brim. And then remember to put about an inch of water or apple juice in the bottom, and then cover. Every now and again, stir them up, and you'll see that as they cook, they mush down. So medium heat, just keep an eye on them. Don't put them on and then walk away. But you don't need to keep stirring. Stirring the steam will help reduce the muscle. Here we are. Our apples have now cooked down. Remember, the apples used to be way up at the top. And we've recruited help for this project. This is our grandson, Logan. Say hi, Logan.
Hi.
And he is going to do the hard part. He is going to turn the Foley mill. This is called a Foley mill. And what you do is you scoop out your apples now that are all mushy. And there's the skins and there's the seeds. You don't want to eat those. So you put it in the Foley mill and then you crank it. It takes muscles to do this. You crank it and crank it. And it smells wonderful in here. It smells like you're on the inside of a caramel apple.
Yeah.
The whole house smells good.
Uh-huh. It's kind of like people are going to be like running.
They're going to run over here, aren't they, just to eat our applesauce.
Like they can smell it right through that window.
Probably.
I can see his muscles building already. Look at that.
Yep. And then now and again go backwards to clean off the scrapers in there. And you can see that you're now, see what's left in there? You've got the skins left in there and some seeds, all those things you don't want to eat. Ready for some more?
Yeah.
All right. Dump some more in there.
Holy cow.
All right, always go clockwise while you're working.
Can you still find that? I almost got it.
You can remember that?
I saw one seed.
Did you?
Yeah.
Let's get that big apple off of there. Wait a minute, that apple is just taking a free ride. Okay. Crank them down. Yep. See how you're mushing them up?
So it's crunchy.
And what a wonderful way for children to figure out where the food comes from in their life. It doesn't just come from a jar. You actually have to prepare it before it goes into the jar.
And the picking process, the growing process, you take it back to a time where people really became more self-sufficient than we are today. We take a lot of things for granted.
Right.
Okay, now.
Okay, should we look at the applesauce that's coming out? Ah, look at that. What wonderful stuff. Oh, it's gonna taste so delicious. Ready for some more?
Yep.
Oh, I'm so glad I've got muscles helping me here. I suppose you're going to want to taste it, too. All right, we'll stop with the... Ooh, we'll start with a big pot this time. Oh, and it smells wonderful.
Can you see it, like, right under there? It's like it comes from those tiny holes.
Yep.
See it dripping?
Mm-hmm.
You see me mushing it through. Wasn't that... Man that made this.
Can you see the steam?
Yes, it's hot. Mr. Foley, who invented this little machine here, really had a good idea. He probably helped his mom with applesauce and he said, there's got to be a better way.
Call me Mr. Mixer.
Okay, Mr. Mixer. Doing a good job.